Hey guys, my name is Matthew, and this is my review of Love People, Use Things, Because the Opposite Never Works, written by the Minimalists. Here we go. Love People, Use Things is like a part memoir, part guide written by the Minimalists. You may be familiar with them. If so, it's probably because you saw their Netflix documentary, although they also have podcasts and YouTube stuff out there as well. As the title of the book suggests, though, it's not just about minimalism in regards to stuff, it's also about relationships and stuff. In this review, I'm going to be listing some of my observations of the book. I'll start with some of the things that I enjoyed the most about the book, and I'll end with a couple things that I didn't like as much. At the end, I'll give my recommendation for who should consider purchasing the book. Love People, Use Things is a book packed with information, and I was actually pleasantly surprised to find that most of it had nothing to do with decluttering. This isn't like a Marie Condo style book of how to get rid of your belongings or something like that. Really, it's a book about relationships and money and creativity and prioritizing your life, and really about living your life intentionally. All these subjects are viewed kind of through the lens of minimalism, and I think for the most part it's done to good effect. All of those things, they relate back to the idea of minimalism and how kind of decluttering your life can help you to do better in all sorts of different places in your life. The book is also pretty entertaining overall, and it moves along at a pretty good pace. It's written informally, so it doesn't feel like you're reading an instruction manual on like how to improve your relationships or something like that. And I enjoyed some of the outside stories that were brought in. I mentioned that a lot of it is kind of memoir-esque from the point of view of the minimalists, but also they brought in outside perspectives. They, you know, some of their readership and people who've written to them, they kind of told their story in this book as well. And I think that really highlights some of the ways that poor focus, like on excessive consumerism, can result in dissatisfaction in life. So I thought that was really good. I think the book was actually written in a way that no matter what stage you're in, whether you see yourself like in the TV show Hoarders or you currently own 36 items and are traveling the country, you could get something of value from this book. I think beginners in the minimalism thing could find the book really approachable and encouraging, even if they don't want to be minimalists. Whereas people who would consider themselves veteran minimalists could even find new aspects of minimalism or perspectives in some other aspect of their life that they hadn't even considered. So I think that is a good strength for the book. And the book itself is really meant to change your life. That's the way that they designed it. They really want you to take the exercises at the end of each chapter and the various pieces of advice that they give and find a way to implement them into your life. They're quick to say, use what's useful and leave what isn't. And they really have lots of practical takeaways throughout the entire book. And I really like that. A couple things I didn't like as much. One thing that struck me as odd was the really excessively long intro. Actually, I was reading through the intro and I didn't really realize that I hadn't started the book yet when they started saying things like, so by the way, the format of this book is going to be blank and we're going to make, in the rest of this book, we're going to be doing this. And I was like, oh, I'm like a quarter way through the book and we're still like introing the book. And so then they actually got into what they were gonna talk about. So I don't know, yeah, that kind of struck me as odd. And then the other thing that I didn't love as much was that the book actually kind of overutilizes Josh and Ryan's personal stories. I think if that's the first time that they'd ever put it in here, then it would make some sense. But I mean, if you've seen their Netflix documentary, if you've read any of the other books, if you've seen them on YouTube, you've heard their stories before. And so it was like this memoir book type situation, and they kept kind of drawing on their stories. But I've seen their stories a lot. And if you're familiar with them at all, you have too. If you're not familiar with them, maybe that's more forgivable, but it just felt like it looked like a weird memoir and it would have helped for them. I think the book would have been better if they'd left those elements out. That's my personal opinion. Now, before I recommend this book, I do just want to point to the description. There is an affiliate link down there. It links directly to Amazon. So if you're going to buy the book, I'd really love it if you use that link. It doesn't cost you any extra, but it does help out our channel immensely. Now, as far as my recommendation, I actually really enjoyed the book. If you're familiar with The Minimalist at all, you kind of already know what you're getting into. There are some familiar stories and elements to this book, but it's still a good read, and it's got some thought-provoking and really helpful practical advice. If you don't know anything about The Minimalists, I think this would actually be a great book for you and just helping you to readjust your priorities, especially if you feel like your life might be a little bloated with consumerism and with things. I think The Minimalists take a pretty simple and really encouraging approach to helping you to make some adjustments in your own life. And I think that can be really, really good. This has been my review of Love People, Use Things. If you've enjoyed this review, if you feel to like and subscribe, we put out reviews for books all the time and other book-related content. In addition to that, we'd love it if you use those affiliate links if you're thinking about buying the book. Thanks again for watching, guys, and as always, stay safe out there.